I am a social justice organizer, and my heart resides in the West End. I was born in the West End, and for a period of time, I was raised in this community. What could potentially take place in this area is an atrocity, and it adds insult to injury when you think about this community went through a period of gentrification in the earlier part of the millennium, in the earlier part of 2000, the 2000s. Now, I'm currently standing at Stargel Stadium, which houses, again, 5,000 individuals. There are six Cincinnati public schools that use Stargel Stadium for games, for practices, so on and so forth. And so when you think about the fact that this is in such close proximity to City West, which is a Cincinnati Metropolitan Housing Authority complex. And for years, Cincinnati Metropolitan Housing has been trying to encourage residents to take the housing choice vouchers. Now, I don't know how many of you are familiar with the rental assistance demonstration, which is a program where private developers can get federal subsidies to house low-income residents and provide affordable housing. We currently have a 40,000 housing unit shortage in the city of Cincinnati. Again, what concerns me is that if you take the stadium, which seats 5,000 individuals, and build a stadium, which at best, at minimum, will have 25,000 patrons at any given time, we're gonna need parking, we're gonna need amenities, and I'm not sure that the individuals who come in this community who already feel that there are a lot of undesirable citizens or they don't like the current element, which if you break down those terms, basically they're saying they don't want to patronize a facility in the heart of a Black community. What I'm hearing individuals say is that in order for them to patronize FC Cincinnati, they're gonna have to bulldoze the area and displace citizens. So the developers, what the owners want or what the owners need to thrive, they will get. And so if it means displacing citizens, that essentially may happen. So going back to the rental assistance demonstration, what they've done in cities throughout the country is they purchased residencies or projects that basically house senior citizens, because senior citizens are the most desirable population for the rental assistance demonstration. They don't tear up the property and they're pleasant and cooperative. They will comply. The sad thing about this is the senior citizens will be offered housing choice vouchers and their options will be limited. So they're going to be essentially going to be stuck in these projects. Now, I understand the most thriving communities are mixed income communities where you have a combination of income levels. I understand that. However, when individuals purchased homes before in this area and the current residents wanted to have activities, youth wanted to have activities in the community, they pretty much determined what they wanted or what they were going to allow in this community and what they were not going to allow in this community. So, just given that as an example, if you have a stadium here that essentially costs $200 to $400 million, where you have low-income residents, if that element is not what the patrons, the owners want, they're going to continue to displace citizens or make it more desirable for their patrons. At the end of the day, it's all about making money. Now, let's go to the fact that the owners of FC Cincinnati are saying that they're footing the entire bill. Actually, they're not footing the entire bill. The stadium itself will be exempt from property taxes. The construction on the stadium will be exempt from sales tax, the development. Now, in the city of Cincinnati and nationwide, but primarily in the city of Cincinnati, because that's what I focused on for a little bit, for a little while, is there is no inclusion. The development contracts have been monopolized. Minority businesses are not only not getting prime contracts, but they're not even getting to work. If you take a tour of the city of Cincinnati, now, to be honest, the entire city of Cincinnati is undergoing gentrification. So it's not just limited to this area, but this is a prime example of where it is taking place. The development contracts have been monopolized. The development contracts have been monopolized for years by two major companies. They are selling. Some of the selling points of this during the current election. Now, let me break this down. In order to get an FC Cincinnati or a Major League Soccer franchise, the soccer owners, Dan, the owner of Major League Soccer, has to approve a league here. The second partner in this would be the West End Community Council. They have to approve this project. The Cincinnati School Board has to approve this project since it's at Taft High School football stadium. And then the community partners are the most viable or are the most important quarter of this. So you have a four-party player. You have Major League Soccer. We don't even know if they're going to approve a soccer franchise in this area or in this city. The West End Community Council, they say that they're not on board and they're just seeing what the community wants. The Cincinnati School Board, they are going to have a meeting here at Taft High School tomorrow at 6 p.m. to engage the community, and then the community has to say what it wants. Now, former Mayor Mark Mallory has said that if the community doesn't want it, he won't put it here. He's going to be a part of the FC Cincinnati deal regardless, no matter where it goes. He is an intricate part of that. So he has pretty much said that if the community doesn't want it, it won't go here. So we just have yet to see. But I want you all to just pay attention to all of these moving parts. Learn what RAD is, R-A-D, the Rental Assistance Demonstration Program. Look at the part that the position the CMHA has taken and these housing choice vouchers, and think about community members. Also, with this being Taft High School, this is not what education is about. Think about what our children need. Kelly Prather, broadcasting live from Taft Information Technology High School in the West End. God bless. Have a good day and goodbye.
Baby, you dropped the bomb on me.